So when you come here on a Saturday morning, although we are making sure that we protect each other, we keep our social distance, we're washing our hands, we are covering our face, nose and mouth to prevent from just catching or even spreading the virus, we are happy that we are here. And today we are going to talk about how God's love is in our lives. So for that reason, we're going to begin with a word of prayer. Okay, let's bow our heads and let us pray. Heavenly Father in heaven, once again, we say thank you. Thank you for bringing us here again once more, bringing our wonderful children here at Adonai Baptist Church to fellowship with you, to learn the word, to be together, to understand the word, so that when they are out there, Lord, they have the vitamin that you want to give them through your Holy Spirit. They are covered by your grace, by your love. They are covered by your blood. And once they are there, Lord, they know who you are all about. We are here today together to learn your love. The love that you have for us, the love that you want us to share with each other. And as we continue throughout the day, we ask that you continue to guide us, protect us, our leaders in the church, our leaders of the youth, our leaders, our young children, our youth, our adults. Keep protecting us, Lord, and help us bring this revival into us, that we continue to serve you because you mean the world to us. You are the one that protects us, that keeps us here, and we want to continue to serve you. And we pray all this in the name of your son, Jesus. And everybody say,
amen.
Amen. So today we have John 3:16. Any of you have something you want to share that happens during the week, you want to be grateful for, or you want to feel loved about? Yes, Ali.
I lost my glasses. Yeah, and then yesterday my dad found them.
Okay.
And I said thank you 2 times.
Very good. That is awesome. Isn't that awesome?
Yes.
When someone does something for you, you have to thank them. His father went to look for his glasses for him, even if his father didn't lose his glasses. This is also love, right? So we want to say thank you. Anybody else want to share? Yes.
My dog had new puppies on New Year's Eve, and now he finally opened their eyes.
Beautiful. You love the puppies?
Yes.
I love puppies too. But a lot of work, right? Okay, take care of the puppies. So anybody else want to say, share? Yes, Ali? Alisa wants to share something.
Because my mom just almost found my glasses, and she said thank you 2 times.
Your mom find your glasses? Wonderful. See, all this is love, because first of all, you have to know where you put your things and be responsible for what you have. So please be responsible for every little bit of things, okay? All right, now today, our scripture, John 3, verse 16. We're going to try to say it together, and then we're going to go through the verse, the Bible story, and then we can share with some questions and any questions you might have. So let's go with John 3, verse 16. Let me see where you know. John 3, verse 16.
John 3, verse 16.
For God so loved the world
that he gave his only begotten Son,
that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish. Beautiful. Once more. Very loud. John 3, verse 16.
John 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Great try. Good job. Verse 16.
John 3, verse 16.
For God so loved the world
that he gave his only begotten Son,
that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish. Beautiful. Once more. Very loud. John 3, verse 16.
John 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
2 sons. Does anybody know what this is all about? A father with his 2 sons. Yes, Ali, your hand was out first.
Jesus told a story to his disciples that a person had 2 sons,
mm-hmm.
and then one of the sons said, "Father, please give me half of your money." So the father divided the money and gave half of it to the son who asked. So the son went away and spent all his money foolishly. And then when he had no money, he realized that he had no food. And the workers that his dad had food. So he went back home, and his dad prepared a feast for him.
Give Ali our hands. Told the whole story we are about to talk about. It means one thing. He's reading his Bible. He's listening to the preachers. He's also listening to his parents when they're telling him about Bible stories. So, and in life, anything you listen to, you can get a lesson from. And he done told the whole story. Give him a round of applause again. Very proud of you. Okay. So now it's going to be your chance now to hear the full story with the scriptures, and then eventually one day somebody asks you, do you know about the story of the father and the 2 sons in the Bible? You will be able to tell what is going on. Correct? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right, now the story is found in Luke 15, verse 1 to 3, and verse 11 to 32. And I will read. Why does Jesus spend time with people who do bad things? The religious wonders. So Jesus told them a story about God's love. Remember, we just learned about that God loved, he so much loved us, he gave us his son. So this is how it went. A man had two sons. The younger son asked for the money he would get when the father died. Heartbroken, the father gave the younger son half of his property, exactly how Ali said, right? So here, we do ask our parents for money, right? Even if they didn't die. But this one is something about inheritance. Inheritance is when your father or your parents die, they leave something behind for you. Depends on how things were while they were living, right? So the son took the money. He moved to a distant country, a far country that is far away, right? He wasted all the money he got. Then famine came. Do you know what famine is? What is it, Ali?
Famine is like when there's no food for a very yes. long time.
That's right. Famine, you lose everything. You don't have food to eat. You don't have money to buy food or anything. So famine comes. He ended having to feed the pigs. Now him feeding the pigs is like going to work. So nobody just feed pigs. You go to feed pigs, you're working so you can get paid. He wished he could eat the pig's food because he has nothing. Remember, he's hungry, he lost all his money, and then now he has to work giving food to the pigs. He wished he could have eaten the food that he was giving to the pigs. But mind you, food that you feed animals are not the food that you eat, correct? That's to tell you how hungry he was because he had nothing. He wasted everything he had. My father's servants do better than this, he thought. I'll return home and admit that I have sinned against him and God. Maybe he'll make me one of his servants. Now he's talking about his father that was so rich. He had people serving him. He has people working for him. And the father would feed them. They would give them food because they used to be, they were very rich and he used to be rich as well. The son went back home while he was still far away. Meaning he was on his way coming to his father's house. He's returning to his father's house because he has nothing. He has nowhere to go. He's coming back home because he's hoping his father can accept him or at least let him work as a servant. His father saw him from far away and ran and hugged him. "Say, I'm not worthy to be your son," the son says. Because he don't do all the things that he was not supposed to do. He was being greedy. He asked for his piece of his wealth. He went and spent it. So he feel like his father would not want him anymore, or his father would not even want to have him as a son. And this father says, "Bring my son, my best robe." You know what's a robe?
Yeah.
No. A robe is a beautiful coat. It's a gown, it's a dress, you would call it, but it's a big robe. Like the choir robe, like a big robe you wear in the morning. The father told his servant, "Put a ring on his finger." Now the ring represents something. "Roast our fattest calf." Do you know what that is?
Food.
Okay, the meat that you eat is literally from an animal. And a beef or a calf is like a young beef. That's what the father was talking about. He was so happy to see his son, he asked to give him the best food ever. "My boy was lost, and he is now found." The older son was angry. Remember, there were two sons, right? The older son was angry when he heard about the celebration. "It's not fair," he said. "I worked faithfully and got nothing. He wasted your money, and now he gets a party. All that is mine is yours," the father says. "Your brother was dead. Now he's alive. He was lost, now he's found. So what can we do to celebrate? What can we do but to celebrate?" Now, tell me, in the story, which person loved the younger son so much that he celebrated his return? Yes, after that.
The father?
Yes.
The dad.
Okay, so the father and the dad. That's to tell us. You guys see the story. Explain how, no matter what or how far we have fallen from God's grace, God's mercy is always around, and God's love is always there to welcome us back. It tells us two things. We are not perfect in the world. When we do something that is bad, we must recognize what we've done is bad and ask for forgiveness and make sure you work towards not doing it again. Your Father will welcome you back home. You are always welcome home, but you have to respect His wishes. You have to see when you are wrong and you come to your Father, right? So Jesus talked about how the Father welcomed His Son back. He was so happy that the Son come back home. He throw a party. He throw everything He can give him, the best food, the best clothing, and welcome him home. Now, the Son that has always been in the house of the Lord, the Son that has always been there with the Father, was not too happy. He was like, I've been there. I've been doing everything, but you never do a party for me. You never, but guess what? The Father said, everything I have is for you. So in life, know that we are children of God. Everything in His kingdom is ours, but we have to make sure we follow His will, right? Now, what did the Son do for a living after He lost all His money? Ali, anybody else? Go ahead, Ali. What did He do when He lost all His money? From partying with friends, from spending all His money, and then now He broke. And then He had to work, what He's never done before. What did He do?
He had to feed the...
He had to work feeding pigs to make some living, right? So what did the Father do when he was coming home? Since you haven't said anything, Deborah.
Got the finest clothes and had a feast.
But before then, what did the Father do when He saw His Son coming from way ahead?
I saw Joe.
Yes, Joe.
He ran to hug him.
He ran to hug him to welcome him home. And then what happened?
And then He said, bring my son the finest clothes and to give him a ring and give him the finest cow.
Yes, because he was so happy He's home. So the Lord is always happy to see when you come in His presence. When you guys gather here on Saturday, God is happy to see that you guys are coming to learn about His word. He's happy to see you coming in His love and His fellowship to be in His presence. So anytime you have the chance to come to the presence of the Lord, just do it. You are not too young to serve God. You're not too young to know that God is your Savior. Right? Anybody with questions? Yes, Krista.
Is coming here the only way we can spend some time with God?
Absolutely not. It's not the only way you can spend time with God. It's one of the means or of the ways you can spend time with God. You can spend time with God at home. You stay in His presence. You read His word. You pray. You can spend time with God coming. But He says, do not abandon His assembly. Because in the assembly, you find teaching. You find encouragement. You find instructions on how to live in God's love. So coming here on Saturdays, that's what we have for you guys. And that's why we can help you learn certain things. Coming to church. Coming to prayer meeting, at home. So a lot of people, when they're at home, they just stay at home. They don't read the Bible. They don't pray. They don't do anything for God. So the assembly, it says, do not abandon. Abandon means do not stay away from the assembly. You come in the presence of the Lord so you can help fellowship and also learn about His word and receive instructions from your leaders to know how to go through life in God's love. Good question, Christelle. Anybody else? Anyone else with questions?
No.
You understand the story?
Yes.
Any comments?
No.
No?
I mean yes.
So what was the story about? Yes, Joe.
The story was like not like to follow God and not like don't be selfish or anything like that. To
give Joe a round of applause. Very not being selfish. Not seeing yourself, but see that what God is doing for you is for your own good. Yes? After that.
The story was about even though the son was far away and suffered with the money and he came back, the father always loved him and he cherished him. And even though he spent all of his money, the father loved him.
Absolutely. You're never too far to come back to God. Find your way back to God. Keep thinking, keep knowing that God loves you and He always would want to see you home. Yes, Crystal?
I think that
brother, when the son returned and came back home, the brother was jealous of him because they had a feast, they had a celebration, and he, inside of his heart, he was jealous.
He was hurt. He was hoping the fact that he was home, he's been home, that he would receive these things, but he was not too happy the way the father did the party. You're absolutely correct. But that doesn't mean he doesn't love his brother. Right? So we always cherish what everybody does for us. So that means if you are home, your sibling does something for you, you still gotta say thank you and show them how much you love them and appreciate them. Don't wait until they leave to do it. Okay? Very good, Christelle. Applause for Christelle. Very good. So the story is about
God.
The story is about
loving God.
I hear it. The story is about
loving God.
The story is about
loving God.
Love. The story is about God's love for his son. The story is about love. So John 3:16.
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
I cannot hear you. By yourself. John 3:16.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Amen. Give yourself a round of applause. You are doing very good. You guys know what song? Yes, Jesus loved me. Jesus loves me. This I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones who have been loved, they always let me in strong. Sing. Yes, Jesus loves me. Come on, sing. Yes, Jesus loves me. I don't hear you. Connected with Jesus because he will guide your path. Correct?
Yes.
Amen. Alright.
So okay. One of them can pray for us.
Yes.
And then we can have some playtime.
Alright. Okay, Aphrodite says she will pray. It has to be loud so we can all hear.
Stand up, guys.
Stand up. By your hands, with your eyes.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for loving us. Thank you for caring for us even though we were far away. You brought us back into your son. Thank you for bringing us all here safe and sound and bless us all in our families. Thank you for giving us our needs and everything we need.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, I pray.
Amen. Amen. Very good.